Hi,
we're
Daniel and Takt, you already know from his great talk. And we want to talk about bio-routing, which is versatile, fast, reliable routing daemon in Golang, as you can see. it's open source. It's founded 2017 by Takt. The initial commit was in April 2018. And we already got 6 contributors in our team. We have nearly 700 commits since April. And bio implementations or implementations running bio or using bio as a library, which we can later, are running in production at Exaring and Mavomato software. Why did we build bio routing?
Why did we actually start another routing daemon? Isn't there enough on the market already, like Quagga and FRR and Bird and OpenBGPD and ExaBGP and GoBGP, and did I forget anyone? In 2016-17 around, I was developing TFlow 2, which is an IPFix NetFlow and SFlow collector. But certain routers are actually lacking certain information in the flow data, namely AS paths, prefixes, and stuff like that. So if you use IPT NetFlow on a Linux router, you don't have the AS information in the NetFlow data. So I had the idea that I need a BGP feed to actually feed this data into TFlow, so actually do queries like, okay, show me all traffic going to a certain ASN or traffic coming from a certain ASN, stuff like that. So my first idea was, okay, I could just set up a BERT next to the TFlow and talk to BERT via the socket with the text protocol and just do a show route all destination IP, get the AS path, scrape the stuff out, but it's actually slow and fragile. So I tried GoBGP, because so I thought, like, okay, maybe I can just put some BGP right into the TFlow binary and let it talk to the router so it gets all the information. I can just look up from a table. But my tests stopped quite quickly. I tried to load a full routing table into GoBGP on a virtual machine that had 1 GB of RAM, and it was swapping immediately. And then I was looking up on the net, like, why is GoBGP taking so much memory? There was an issue on GitHub. Somebody was complaining about the memory consumption of GoBGP, and the reply from developers was, memory efficiency is a non-goal of the project. And had a further look into the code, why it is actually taking so much memory, and the reason in GoBGP is that it's representing prefixes as strings and storing the JSONC rip in as a hash map where the index is the string of the prefix.
Like IPv6, very easy.
Oh, yeah. Works great with IPv6. You have long strings taking lots of space. Also, if you want the longest prefix match, that's what I need usually in my case, because I want to know which prefix was actually used to forward the traffic to see where it was really going. It always means in GoBGP to traverse the whole adjacency ribbon as a table. So you walk the full table of 750,000 routes, and then you convert the prefix into a proper representation that allows you to actually check if the IP address is in the prefix. Then you just pick the one with the longest prefix, and it takes huge amounts of CPU. So the solution was write your own, because obviously they were not interested in me patching anything, because it would be memory optimization, and it's not what they are looking for. So I didn't even try to send patches. So I actually started writing my own, because there was nothing suitable for my use case.
We've got another few points why we started writing bio. We love BERT, we run BERT in production, but it's pretty much a monoculture at the moment. This was pointed out in several talks by big IXPs, so we wanted to contribute a new solution for that, and we found out that there's a general lacking of multi-core support in routing daemons.
Yeah, both open source and commercial. Like, I only know of one commercial available version at the moment, the BGP implementation, that is really utilizing multiple CPUs for path selection. And there's one more that's open source, and that's us.
Yeah. Pretty small one, but it's growing. So we got Linux as our target platform, because we all run Linux, and we are happy with it. So we are not a real competitor for OpenPGPD, which is a great project, but they are targeting BSD at the moment, so we have a good coexistence. And we wanted to get a new approach with writing something which is not C.
Yeah, it's basically using a modern language is getting more, getting used more and more, like Golang, that really simplifies building fast, reliable software. I mean, also, if I would have written TFlow not in Go but in C, I could just have used BERT as a library and get the BGP data right into TFlow. But TFlow is not written in C, and I don't want to write any C software anymore because C.
It's hard. It's difficult.
It's hard, it's difficult, it takes time, and then it check faults.
Mental ability.
At least for me, it does.
Yeah. So we agreed on some key concepts and some focuses for the start in April, and we wanted to have it open source. So we agreed on Apache 2.0 license. We want to focus primarily on performance and memory efficiency.
Which is a hard trade-off, actually, because you can always swap performance with memory.
Yeah.
We're trying to find a proper way not to waste too much memory, but actually get a speed gain as well.
We do not use string representations for IPs in our internals, so it's all in.
That makes it a bit better already.
Yes. Yeah, I think so. Was quite hard to figure out which is the right way, but it works quite good at the moment. We want to have Bio as a library. So you can take Bio, put it into your Go project, and have a full-featured BGP speaker in your application. So your application can speak BGP directly with your core router or something like that.
Well, not just BGP.
Yeah.
Bio, the way, sets for BGP, ISIS, and OSPF, because that's the main things that we're focusing on. I'm also heavily working on ISIS at the moment. Level 2 support is going to be there soon, hopefully.
Let's say later.
OSPF, there's nothing done yet, but I think that work will start soon.
Yeah. Also, we want to provide Bio as a full-featured routing daemon solution to be used by IXPs or something like that. Your network.
Yeah, basically for people who don't want to dig into the code and
just
use it as library.
Since we are both gRPC fans, and he's the biggest fanboy I know, we want to have all libraries, all APIs for the library and the routing daemon in gRPC, which is pretty much done.
There's quite some stuff already.
Yeah.
But there's no CLI tool, for example, at the moment, and we want to use, between the CLI tool and the daemon, we want to use gRPC. So you can actually just pull the data, you get it in a decent format, and you don't need to do any text scraping anymore to get data out of your routing daemon like you have to do with BERT or Quagga or stuff like that. And also we want to have native Prometheus integration, so you just have a text HTTP endpoint where all the metrics are falling out, and we're going to export as many internal metrics as possible, so we get a decent idea what is the state within Bio. But there's a lot of work to be done still at the moment.
Exactly. So we got a few features done since April, which is not so bad, I think. We got AdPath in RX and TX. We got communities and large communities. In fact, we got large communities before communities. We got 32-bit ASN support. We got multi-protocol IPv4, IPv6 unicast support, which is not done perfectly already, but will be later this year. We got route reflection support. We support route servers. Tucked already added a BMP receiver because it's needed on Exaring. And we, in the last days, got support for Netlink, so we can push routes and pull routes from the Linux kernel. So I'm running bio as a library too. I've got a small route injector which injects my RTBH routes into my core router and edge router, and the source code is available at GitHub. It has an API which is gRPC.
Obviously.
And persists its state in a small SQLite database, so that if the server is if the service restarts, the routes are there, so you don't lose your black hole routes. Also, metrics and distributed tracing are added using OpenCensus, which is a neat way to add metrics and tracing information and telemetry as a whole to your project.
Lessons learned. We read a lot of RFCs. It can be fun, but also turns out some RFCs are quite confusing, at least to us. And sometimes it's hard to get things right, and you implement stuff, and then you test it with the real world, and then it turns out that somehow other vendors have read that document differently than we did, but they all did it the same way, so we had to adjust to the way they do it, because otherwise we have interop issues. We are now able to properly implement the observer pattern, because the concept in bio is that routing tables are clients of other routing tables. They just subscribe to information that they need. So if you have JSONC rip out, for example, it's just a client of the local rip, and stuff gets propagated through the software. 100% test coverage is cool, but not necessarily enough if you don't test the right things. Like we had issues on our try that we used to represent routing tables. And actually, I thought that I tested everything, and then at some point we just push the full table into it, and then we withdraw the full table, and somehow 6,000 routes have been left over in the rip.
They want to stay. So.
Yeah, finding deadlocks is also an issue. If you are sharing memory and you work with logs, it's hard to keep track.
Yeah, and we got quite a lot of issues. Concurrency in bio.
Yeah, I mean we're aiming for velocity here. So we are doing as much as possible in a concurrent way. Whatever is possible to do it concurrently, we try to do that. But it could lead to deadlocks if you don't do it properly. In the terms send and receive, especially your netpath, it is based on the view. So if you receive the capability from your peer, it says, I'm able to do netpath receive. It actually means you are allowed to send, and you should get the naming of the variables properly, otherwise you just screw it up. And
if you come back,
I think we implemented some stuff then twice and cleaned it up in the end.
Yep, and we changed the point of view in the process of a route information processing different stages of bio, which wasn't a good idea indeed.
Yeah.
So what we're planning for the future, like Tag has already said, we are nearly there to get ISIS support for L2. We want to have flow spec support Q1 2019. OSPF is planned also, but there's no date yet. And we also want a CLI tool, which is like BirdC or something like that, to query your route information in bio and get them out.
Yeah, also in ISIS, segment routing will probably be there from day one. I have no idea when we will add L1 support, if you do it at all. We'll see, because I personally think that L2 is the most important part that we need here. Yeah, source code is available on GitHub, biorouting/biorg. If you want to become a developer, you're very welcome. We have certain guidelines on the code quality, but just send us your pull requests and we will discuss if they're meeting the requirements or not. I don't want to deny anyone from contributing. So if you think you have the expertise working on routing protocols, OSPF, ISIS, or BGP, or if you have any, if you want to test our software and you have any bugs, come to us, file a bug report on GitHub, or send a pull request, and we're happy to take your contributions.
Indeed. Thank you for your attention. If there's...
At most time for one question, I would say.
I think so.
Hi, Stefan Jakob von Denik. Ich hab mir schon mal euren Code angeguckt und, also sorry, in Englisch. I already looked at the code at GitHub, so I'm still missing an entry point as a user, so how can I get started? So how does the configuration look like? Do I have to wrap Go code around it and so on?
At the moment, you have to write Go code. There's no configuration layer, but it's planned and it will be there.
That's my current understanding, so I was wondering.
Hi, Sebastian from DTAG, and if I remember correctly, when I saw the site where you had your policies and targets for bio, I mentioned one thing missing: memory efficiency. So often, it seems to be a non-goal for your project, right?
It is a goal, obviously, yes. So we're aiming for memory efficiency by using proper data structures, but not for swapping it with performance. I think that's all we can say.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, further questions? Perfect. Okay, so then we will have a break now. The ratings for the talks for this block are already online on dnoc10.dnoc.de. So feel free to go and rate the talks. Otherwise, we'll see you back in 1 hour.